What are these two searching for? Well, that's not really important. What are you looking for? If you're looking for the search algorithms, such as the Iterative Deepening search algorithm, you're in the right place. The Iterative Deepening search is also called the Iterative Deepening Depth First search. Just to be clear, we've done the videos on the Breadth First search, the Depth First search, and the Depth Limited search, and these are uninformed searches. We'll continue after this video with the uniform cost search, and we're explaining the logic behind these. And if you want to know about the time and space complexity, we'll cover that in a further video. Let's have a look at an example of this iterative deepening. Well, what we do here, we go through each level or each depth. So we start off at depth 0, which is just the root node. You can see we're using a stack. What about depth 1? So here, we start off with the root node. As with the deep first search, we put in the children nodes in reverse order. So 10, 9 and 2. So then we can pop 2 first, which we do, then the 9, then the 10. You can see we have visited the nodes up to that level of 1, but not below. Iterative deepening, meaning we're going deeper iteratively. So next level, depth 2. Here you can see the same tree. We're going through the same nodes again. We're repeatedly going through the nodes. So we go through the root node. We go through the children node. So we start with 2. But here we've got 3 and 4. So we put them in our stack. Now we pop out 3, then 4, then 9, then 10. So you can see we're using a depth first search, but we're doing it layer by layer, depth by depth. So now depth 3, we start off with our root node in our stack, and then we pop back the children. Again, 10, 9, 2 go in the stack. When we pop the next one, which is 2, we put the 3 and 4 in reverse order, obviously. Then we look at the 3, then the 4. We've now got the 5, 6 and 7 in our stack. And now we're going to go to the 5, and to the 6, and to the 7, and the 9, and the 10. Now finally, the depth 4 here, we're going to go through the root node 1. Then we've got 2, 9 and 10 in the stack. We go through pop 2, we've got 3 and 4, pop 3, pop 4, we've got 5, 6, 7 in the stack. Pop 5, we've got 8 in the stack. We visit the 8 because it's like the depth first search. And then we go through the remaining numbers, the 6, the 7, the 9 and then the 10. So you can see there we iteratively go through each depth, each level, and we use the depth first search approach, looking at each node up to that level. Okay, what about a graph? Well, how about this for a challenge? What's the order of the elements with an iteratively deepening search, or an iterative deepening search, to the depth level of 2? Okay, let's have a look at the code. Well, here's our tree in the form of a graph. This is the code for a depth limited search we used in the last video. We're showing you this because this is the exact code we're using now with the graph, the add edge, add node, and the creating the graph. But with the DLS, you can see here, we're going to call that function from the iterative deepening search function. And normally with this code, we're looking for a specific node, which we're going to call a target. So for example, here we've got a target 8. So we're looking for the node 8. Maximum depth equals 4. We start at 1. If we find it, we say target found. And if we don't, target not found. So let's have a look at the code in the editor. Okay, here we have the code that we had before for the depth limited search. We had the graph as we've had before, and we have a depth limit to limit the depth. The slightly difference with the iterative deepening search is that we're going to have a target, and also we're going to call the depth limited search. So we call it on the depth of 0, then 1, then 2, 3, etc. So the code is pretty much the same as we've seen before. We create our tree or graph. Here we've got a target, so for example the node 8, maximum depth of 4, and if we run this, we've got some print statements in here. You can see that the code, we visit node 1, then we visit node 1, 2, 9 and 10, as you've seen in the example from the slides, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 9, 10, and here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 10, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8, 6, 7, 9, 10. And because we found that node 8, we've found our target. So this is the code. It's almost identical to what we had before, except for we've added the target and we call the depth limited search on each depth as we go down 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. Now you can see that output. You can see we've visited the different levels and the nodes at those levels, and we found our target 8. Now the solution with the graph, remember, we're going to look at the iterative deepening search, level 2. So here we have our graph. We start off at level 0, which is just the 1. Then at level 1, you can see here, we've got the 1, 2, 5, then 3. And then the next level 2, we're going to go to the 1, the 2, the 4, then the 7, then the 5, then the 3, and then the 6. And that finishes level 2. So that was the iterative deepening search on a graph. Okay, let's have a look at that code. Now we have the same code for the graph as we had before when we implemented the tree in the graph form. And here we can run the code, and we can just see here we've got the level 0, the level 1, the level 2. So these are the nodes we visited. We can look at the code from the top. It's the same as we did for the tree example, and it's very similar to the depth limited search, except for we call the function for each level. So this seems quite an inefficient way of doing things. So why is this an approach that we use? Well, the concerns is that we're repeatedly visiting nodes. But if you think about it, there are more nodes at the lowest level. So it's not as inefficient as you would think. But we do have a problem when, as you can see in this diagram, we've got 1 that goes to 3, 3 goes to 2. We're going back to 2 when we've already visited. So these like silly graphs means we have inefficiencies. Well, the problem with breadth first search is that we store every node, so we don't need to do that in this approach. And if we had depth first search, then every option in the second half would take ages if we have a lot of things in the first half of the tree. So the left hand side of the tree, if that's like infinite or has a lot, then it's very inefficient. And the depth limited search might not find a solution. So the example here is a maze. So if you had a maze, it would be very memory exhaustive using the breadth first search. If the wrong way was the first, like let's say going left was the wrong way in the maze, then the depth first search would take you through all of the wrong options, and the depth limited search might not be able to come out of the maze because it's limited in how far it went. So these are some of the reasons we may consider using this approach or not using it. And we will go into the details of time and space complexity and efficiency in a future video. There is a great new opportunity for anyone interested in learning about Python or any other areas of computing. In the next year, new courses will be added to the ALPS Academy, and they will be available to you for free. Written by university professors, they will be specifically designed for international students, which means they'll be easy to understand using simple language. They will even be helped to improve your English, if you're interested. How can this help you? Well, leave a comment. Any suggestions you make could be turned into a course. Motivated learners deserve equal access to opportunities. Help us to help you. Okay, if you enjoyed that, please remember to like, and if you haven't already, please subscribe.